this was literally the first thing I had on hand that was anime related, so take from that what you will. Salutations, Cinemascus. I'm Darkest101, and welcome back to Darkest101 Reviews, and welcome back to AniMonth. All throughout the month of March, we'll be going through all things anime-related. So, Bakugan. This is like the illegitimate love child of Digimon and Pokemon, yes? Bakugan. Another one of those animes where powerful creatures are forced to battle each other on behalf of children. Happening Digimon Tamers, Yu-Gi-Oh, Pokemon, why the fuck should this anime trope ever die? The original premise of Bakugan also makes absolutely no fucking sense, by the way. I mean, these cards and these creatures just appear out of nowhere, and kids just magically somehow manage to make a game out of these without any adult input whatsoever. And more to the point, these creatures actually follow the rules set out by these kids in this game that they are fucking made up. Yeah, I call bullshit on this. Improbability of the premise aside, I remember enjoying Bakugan when it was first running on Cartoon Network. Side note, you have absolutely no fucking idea how difficult it is to get Bakugan for home media. Anyway, when I heard about there being a Bakugan video game being released, I was interested way back when it first came out, all the way in 2009. I think it might have been my Christmas present for that year. I was a weird 13-year-old, alright? All my friends were getting excited about a new Call of Duty being released. There I was, getting all excited for a video game based off an anime that was broadcast on Cartoon fucking Network. And oh boy, I feel bad for anyone who didn't watch the anime before playing this game, because oh my word, this is it's not accessible in the slightest. This is a game purely made for fans of the anime. The only explanation you get is the opening monologue from the beginning of every episode of the anime played right before the start of the game. There is literally no explanation as to the appearance or relationship of any of the characters in this game other than the opening narration. But don't worry, the game will go into great fucking vagary in order to explain how to play it. By that I mean, that's great detail explained in vague terms. Fun. How a game of Bakugan works is that every player has 3 Bakugan, 3 gate cards, and 3 ability cards. Gate cards are where Bakugan fight each other, and they also power a Bakugan before the fight, depending on their type or any other conditions applied. Ability cards are used to further power up your Bakugan during battle. The player to win 3 gate cards is the victor. You can win gate cards by winning a battle between Bakugan on a gate card, standing 2 of your Bakugan on a gate card, or if all your Bakugan are on the field, performing a stay, which is won by selecting one of your 3 Bakugan to remain on the field for a further turn. The main part of gameplay in the Brawls is where you throw your Bakugan onto the field and onto a gate card. You don't get to control them in their giant monster form to fight other Bakugan, no. You get to control your Bakugan in their shitey marble form. Fun. What do in the marble form? Roll around and pick up power-ups to help out in the actual battles, which are comprised out of 1 of 3 mini-games, each with 3 stages of difficulty. Now then, the marble throwing and controlling wouldn't be so bad if it weren't for the fact of the PlayStation 3's absolutely disgusting motion controls. I may just be spoiled by how precise, responsive, and, you know, good the DualShock 4's motion controls are, or my DualShock 3 might just be a broken piece of second-hand dog shit. Either way, the DualShock 3's motion controls for this game controls like absolute ass. The only time it works properly is when you use it to shake the fucking shit out of it in one of the mini-games inside of the battles. When you're trying to perform tight, precise movements and jumps, it completely fails. What's wrong with just using a simple driving control setup? Why do you have to use weird motion controls? I mean, the game even tells you you can use the analog sticks to control the motion of the Bakugan, so why and try and force this bullshit peripheral? The game of Bakugan itself is extremely limited in your customization options in terms of your cards. You can customize whatever Bakugan setup you want and even level up your Bakugan however the hell you want to, but your cards? Yeah, There are 3 types of gate cards and 3 types of ability cards. You can only have 3 gate cards and 3 ability cards in your deck. I accept this as a limitation and does force you to think strategically about how you'll play the game. What I do not accept is the fact that you can only have 1 of each colour of each type of card. Like seriously, the gold gate cards only offer bonuses for the Bakugan they're named after. Why can't I take 2 copper gate cards at the least? Then I can mix up my strategy. Let me have a little bit more of a risk-reward system. More strategic options, you know? Where do you buy Bakugan and gate cards and ability cards to customize your Bakugan deck, however? From the most terrifying merchant in gaming history. Holy shit, Gabe, you could not have made this more unintentionally horrifying if you tried. This dead-eyed, cell-shaded puppet just stares into my fucking soul. Jesus Christ! This isn't something that's universal across all character models, by the way. This is unique to Alice the Merchant. It is terrifying. It's like she's thinking about all the sins she's ever committed, all the lives she's taken, all the lives she's planning to take. Will it ever be enough? Will she ever be truly satisfied? Maybe. Just one more. We'll finally give her the release she craves. How fucking out of it was I when I wrote that? Oh, and before I forget, these are the main characters in the anime. Dan, Shun, Marucho, Runo, Julie, and Alice. Their personality traits? Jesus-kun, broody, nerd, bad-tempered, girl, and secret sociopath. And on top of that colourful and diverse cast of character tropes, there's the salted cracker you play. Oh, my word, you play the blandest, most generic, by-the-numbers, self-insert character in the whole goddamn universe. And the voice actor does not help. I don't know who did the voice for this kid, but there was nothing put into this performance. No emoting, no nothing. It's just the same near monotone delivery throughout. He never sounds disappointed, he never sounds upset, he never sounds angry, he's just constantly casually upbeat. And if it wasn't already obvious by that, this is a self-insert story. Yay! I don't have a problem with self-insert stories when it comes to anime, but that's only if it's done well. I can't really think of many self-insert games that do it well, except for maybe Dragon Ball Xenoverse. That's a self-insert story done well. This is just making up a random story in and around the anime of Bakugan. It almost makes me wish they'd gone the typical Dragon Ball Z game route and just let me play the story of the anime as the characters of the anime. I genuinely wish that they had gone that road instead of creating this bullshit self-insert story. The anime story path might have lasted longer anyway. Instead, we get generic McDumbass here, someone who literally just started learning how to play Bakugan and then becoming the greatest player in the world in like the space of 24 hours. There are genuinely no time markers in this game. Like, seriously, you could be forgiven for thinking that this entire game takes place over the space of a day, because it's like, it just seems like there's a bunch of different tournaments happening in the space of a couple of hours. It's weird. So the game, like I said earlier, just assumes you saw the anime and that you know what the story is, what the Hell of Doom dimension is, and why any of this has any impact on your builder brawler here. We see anime Big Bad, who we never fight in the game, get a flash of some random dark place, and then boom, your character's complaining that he doesn't know how to play Bakugan and is being forced into a brawl. That's literally all the sense of an introduction you get into the world of Bakugan in this game, save the opening narration. Don't understand it? Fuck you. This is also one of those stories where every character in the game is immediately interested and invested in the character you created after literally just being made aware he exists. Or hell, after he even just pops into existence. Like, Dan finds him getting bullied and in a pug, and is immediately like, you and I will be friends forever, can you suck my dick because I'm your hero? And while Dan is all about getting that sweet, sweet hero worship, everyone else in the Bakugan cast is immediately curious and interested in your brand new, unique partner Bakugan. Despite the fact that literally every character in the main cast of the Bakugan story has a unique partner Bakugan. Like seriously, secondary antagonists have partner Bakugan, alright, that are unique to them and never seen anywhere else in the story. Why is this kid showing up with a brand new Bakugan you've never heard of worth jumping on this kid's dick about? I mean, they're suspicious about a new kid playing a game really well with a Bakugan they've never heard of, but they only have their suspicions to work off of. No hard evidence or anything like that, no character references. I get that they're not detectives, but they just assume that your Bakugan is evil because you're good at the game. They do research and ask other players, and then they hear about a guy playing dirty and beating Dan and Drago, and they just immediately assume it was you, despite the fact that you literally just played in a tag team tournament with Dan. Which, surprise, surprise, leads you into a confrontation with the real villain of this game, Marduk and Vladator. And game, I know you're trying, but you cannot have me be intimidated by someone called Marduk. Seriously, you might as well have just called him Marquack or Marcock, because what the hell is that cocktail ponytail he's got going on? And despite you being literally a third of the way through the story at this point, the central conflict from then on is you defeating Marduk, despite the fact that you only fight him again at the end of the fucking story, and you've already beaten him once, so why are we meant to be intimidated by this guy we just met and who we fucking steamrolled? The final tournament of the game is utter horse dick, by the way. You have to fight all the Brawlers and the anime antagonist Masquerade, but all of their partner Bakugan have evolved. Because, you know, that's fair, right? All of this leads to the tournament final where you beat the ever-loving snot out of Marduk and Vladator. Which, you know, somehow leads to Vladator evolving, becoming more powerful and then threatening to consume the entire world in the Doom Dimension. That escalated quickly! All of which results in that age-old anime trope of all the heroes giving their power to the central character, which in this case is you and your partner Bakugan, Leonidas. And then of course you defeat the evolved Vladator with the evolved Leonidas, resulting in the world being saved and... Look! There is no real plot here. There's no real plot to this game, but what plot that does exist is fucking straightforward and boring. The game is more of an excuse to insert your OC into the Bakugan universe and create a Bakugan dream team all of your own. And while the game does play around with a few interesting mechanics, shall we say, the game doesn't capitalize on the main thing it had going for it, which was the monster fights of the anime. Instead, those awesome fights are reduced to a few sort animations that don't change from Bakugan to Bakugan, and instead reduces the fights themselves to a repetitive series of minigames. The story is non-existent, and the characters equally so. It's just an excuse to utilize and capitalize on the Bakugan license and the hype around its heyday. And while it might be mildly entertaining in some aspects, the sickeningly fucked up motion controls render any enjoyment you get from controlling the Marvel Forms of the Bakugan short-lived. There is a good Bakugan game somewhere in this mess. I can almost see it. As it stands, however, the experience of Bakugan Battle Brawlers is a lacking one. That's why it's a dark rating of 43.
How've you been, partner?
And that was the first review of AniMonth. I hope you guys enjoyed today's review. If you have a suggestion for a future review, please leave it in the comment section below. Drop a line on me at Twitter. I think Google Plus is still active somewhere along the line. Might just be buried in fucking dust. I don't know. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this review. I've been Darkest101. You have been watching Darkest101 Reviews. Thanks for watching. Fucking nightmares.